हेलो एवरीवन, आई मिस्टर विशाल शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, कृष्णा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी कराड, वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस सेशन ऑफ द फार्मास्यूटिकल एनालिसिस। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द लिमिट टेस्ट फॉर द सल्फेट। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कवर्ड विद द लिमिट टेस्ट फॉर द क्लोराइड। If you have not watched my previous video related to the limit test for the chloride, you can watch my previous video also related to the pharmaceutical analysis. And if you like the content of this my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. So let's begin with our today's session, that is on the limit test for the sulfate. Now before starting this our today's session, just we will see what are the learning outcomes of this session. So after this session, students will be able to explain the statement, reaction, as well as the principle involved in the limit test for the sulfate. So what is the meaning of limit test for the sulfate? So limit test for the sulfate is again used to control the impurities of the sulfate that are present in the inorganic substances. So in previous video regarding the limit test for the chloride, we have seen that limit test for the chloride is used to control the impurities that are related to the chlorides. In a similar way, this limit test for the sulfate is designed to control the sulfate impurities that are occurring in the inorganic substances. Again, this limit test is based upon the simple reaction between the barium chloride, which are we are going to add it to the our solution, and the soluble sulfate in presence of a acetic acid, which gives us insoluble barium sulfate. So like the chloride, this principle and statement is quite same, where this limit test is based upon the simple reaction between the barium chloride and the soluble sulfate in presence of a acetic acid to give a insoluble barium sulfate. And again here also opalescence of barium sulfate is produced. So this opalescence that is produced in the test is compared with the standard opalescence that is obtained from the standard sulfate solution. So here we are going to carry out the comparison of our test opalescence with the standard opalescence. How this standard opalescence is formed, that is obtained from the reaction between the standard sulfate solution, which is consisting of known amount of sulfate, and the reaction of that with the barium chloride. In this way, this standard opalescence is produced. And if the test opalescence is less intense than that of the standard opalescence, then the sample passes the limit test for the sulfate, and vice versa. If it is more, then the sample does not passes the limit test for the sulfate. Usually, like our chloride and sulfate, these both the limit tests are related to each other, in which both the test we are going to carry out the formation of the opalescence and comparing that opalescence with the standard. So here this sulfate that is present in our sample in the soluble form is reacted with the barium chloride in presence of the acetic acid to give a barium sulfate. The precipitate of barium sulfate is formed, which is insoluble in nature, and in addition to that there will be formation of the chloride. So this barium sulfate that is formed, which produces the opalescence that we are going to compare with the our standard. So here just we are going to take some precautions or different notes why we are going to use the different reagents. So here the solubility of barium sulfate precipitate is largely affected by the concentration of the acid. So if the concentration of acid is different, then the solubility of barium sulfate will be different. So the acidity of the solution is controlled by the acetic acid. So what is the role of acetic acid? To control the acidity of the solution. So it makes the solution acidic so that barium sulfate is not gets dissolved. Then ethanolic sulfate standard solution. So whatever the standard solution that we are going to use, this standard solution, that is ethanolic solution, is used, is added to increase the sensitivity of the test. Then the ionic concentration is adjusted in a such a manner that the solubility product of the barium sulfate gets exceeded, and traces of the barium sulfate present assist the rapid and complete precipitation by the seeding. So this is the technique by which we are going to carry out the precipitation of the barium sulfate. Sometimes what happens, if solubility product is not exceeded, complete precipitation is not observed. So that here, to achieve the complete precipitation, the solubility product of barium sulfate needs to be exceeded. Ethanol prevents supersaturation and helps in producing a more uniform opalescence, and that's why ethanolic standard sulfated solution is generally used. So these are the things that you need to understand and keep in mind. Now we will see which are the different solutions that needs to be prepared for the limit test for the sulfate. First one is the 25% weight by volume barium chloride solution. As here it represents the weight by volume, we have to take 100 ml of solvent, to which we have to add 25 gram of the barium chloride. So dissolve 25 gram of barium chloride in a sufficient distilled water to produce the total 100 ml solution. So this is the way by which we can prepare the barium chloride solution. Then next one is the ethanolic sulfate standard solution, which is having a pharmacopeial concentration as a 10 ppm. So this is the maximum concentration below which our test sample should show. Actually, by using limit test, we are not able to find the exact concentration, but we can identify whether our sample is consisting of the sulfate more than 10 ppm or less than. If it is more than 10 ppm, then we cannot use as a pharmaceutical substance. Or if it is less than 10 ppm, then definitely we can use this particular substance for the pharmaceutical purpose. Now, dilute one volume of 0.181% weight by volume solution of potassium sulfate in ethanol, that is the 30% ethanol, to 100 volumes with the ethanol. So in this way, we are going to prepare the ethanolic sulfate standard solution. Then sometimes if you are going to use the sulfate standard solution, either of this is to be used, because we know ethanolic sulfate solution is used to increase the sensitivity of the test, and this is again similarly, that is dilute one volume of a 0.181% weight by volume solution of potassium sulfate in a distilled water to produce the 100 volumes with the distilled water. Then dilute HCl approximately 10% weight by weight of concentrated hydrochloric acid is required. So 10 gram, just we can convert it into the volume by using the density, and we are going to carry out the addition to the water, 100 ml water. Then we will take the similar example with help of the substance NaCl. We will see how this limit test for the sulfate is carried out. So as I mentioned in the previous video also, here these are the Messler cylinders specifically used for the performing the limit test, which are having the capacity of about 50 ml. So 50 ml and 25 ml mark is present, and up to which we are going to carry out the addition of the different solvent. So first point, we have to take for the test samples. So you can consider this as a test sample. This is your standard sample. In case of this, as we are going to perform this limit test for the sodium chloride, we are going to take 2 gram of sodium chloride in a 10 ml of test solution, that is the 10 ml of distilled water in which we are going to carry out the dissolution, and 15 ml of standard solution, which is having the concentration of 10 ppm. Then to this solution, we are going to carry out the addition of 2 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid. So we are going to maintain the identical conditions in both test sample as well as the our standard sample. So after that, we are going to carry out the addition of the distilled water means we have to carry out the dilution up to 45 ml with the distilled water in both the solution, that is the test sample as well as the standard sample. Once we have carried out the dilution with the help of the our distilled water up to 45 ml, next we are going to carry out the addition of 5 ml of barium sulfate reagent. Now as we know that there is a reaction of barium sulfate with the help of the sulfate which leads into the formation, here you have to add the barium chloride, not barium sulfate. So barium chloride, as when it is added, there will be formation of precipitate of barium sulfate will takes place. So in this way, just you can see over here also, as you can see in the test sample, there is a formation of the less opalescence, less turbid solution, from which we can interpret that if the opalescence that is produced in the test solution is less as compared to the standard solution, then our sample passes the limit test. In this way, we can perform the limit test for the sulfate on the basis of the limit test for the chloride similarly. So this is about the limit test for the sulfate. Now you have to answer this question. The limit test is based upon the simple reaction between dash dash. You have to go to this particular website www.menti.com. You have to use this code 36954443 and you have to answer the question that are provided over here. If you have any queries related to the pharmaceutical analysis, you can contact me on my mail ID. And if you like the content of this my YouTube channel, please like my videos, share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel to get the more videos related to the pharmaceutical analysis. Thank you. Thank you very much for supporting me.